Aloha and good afternoon, good evening. I'm in California right now, and I just wanted to give you a few observations from coming from, you know, the Big Island, which is a super pristine, clean place, to Los Angeles area. What an experience to be able to live in paradise and then come back to a beautiful place. Let me show you. I'm staying at my dad's place here on the lake, and you can see this is a beautiful area, but it is also very synthetic and toxic. You know, I put a shower dechlorinator on here just to be able to, you know, stay away from chlorine, but you got to be way more conscious than just a shower dechlorinator. I mean, that helps a lot, believe me, but if you're going to wash your face or brush your teeth, you want to use distilled water or some type of fresh, clean water source to be able to get away from the chlorine on every layer that you can. You wouldn't believe how much toxicity is just in the water. Forget about the air. Forget about, you know, the pollution from all the cars, all the Wi-Fi, all the con job on the food that just smells everywhere you go. No wonder people can't stay too healthy in the city. We're about 60 miles north of Los Angeles here, called Westlake, and I'm on the island, and it is a super beautiful place. Problem is that everything you see here is fake. It's not really fake, but it is. It's synthetic. It's all man-made. The lake's man-made. Everything you see in positions are all man-made, and that's not a bad thing. It's just that the convenient world is a very toxic world, so you really gotta be smart when you live in the city and or you're being provided your water from the city supply. It's got fluoride in it, chlorine or chloramine, which is chlorine and ammonia, and a sort of assortment of all different types of chemicals, rust, lead in the pipes, copper in the pipes, and everything else. Now, if you're not on a detox diet, that's not so good, because living in the city alone, even if you're in a beautiful place like this and you can see the sky, today there's no chemtrails and it's a beautiful, clean, clean day. Yesterday was miserable. There was chemtrails, you can see them being sprayed over in that quadrant way over there, over the mountain. And, you know, I went on this morning it was 41 degrees, and you can see my feet. I went on a 5-mile barefoot hike, and the barefoot hike is to ground me. It's one of the best things you can do if you live in this world. You have to ground yourself and reset yourself back to nature, because the Wi-Fi, just all the poisons, all the unnatural systems, the only way you could really beat it is to be able to get into nature and really immerse yourself. You know, there's the most beautiful swans here on the lake. And when you really look at these creatures, just like me looking at these flowers here, as you can see, we're living on a planet called the Living Library. And it's got all these beautiful different species of plants, animals, birds, fish, everything you can imagine. If you think this came from just evolution, remember, you've bought into a good story, just like a lot of the stories they tell us about religions and just a lot of history, his story, his story. It's not her story, okay? It's not any other story, but his story. So you can see how the information has been skewed. And who gives the history or the his story? The winner. So what we've been taught has mostly been a load of malarkey. It's just to be able to make ourselves feel, well, really special that we're the only life in the galaxy. You know, there's over 400 million Earth-sized water planets that they've found. They're everywhere, okay? You can look up what's called star water, and you can see how water is something that's very common in the galaxy. It's not something as special as you think. Water is what gives life to everything. Everything and anything. So without water, of course, we really don't have anything. So be very careful about the water that you use. And like I said, even if you're using a shower dechlorinator, I have a whole house system on mine. That's the best way to really, you know, change your water supply. If you use a shower dechlorinator, like I said, that's the next best thing. Nothing wrong with that. But you don't want to wash your face, brush your teeth. You don't want to use the water pretty much for anything but for washing. That's it. Try to get a steam distiller unit. We have those on eartheracademy.com. We have a special deal for everybody that I've made with the company that makes these distillers. You get 2 1-gallon jugs. 1 gallon glass jugs, because you don't want to keep water in plastic at all. And you get a whole year's worth of carbon filters to take the VOCs out that are produced sometimes by the steam distiller. Now, I got my sun today. As you can see, I'm still getting it right now. It's just about sundown. It's about almost 5 o'clock. And it's very, very, like I said, important to be able to try to immerse yourself in nature, and that will definitely reset you from the synthetic world that is very, very assaulting. So, you know, try to eat a lot of greens, super greens, chlorella, blue-green algae, spirulina, brown seaweed extract. Make sure you put your iodine on your wrist 3 times a week. Get your iodine so your thyroid, so go ahead and keep fully active. Remember, your thyroid works off of iodine. If you're not eating sea vegetables, most likely, you're not getting enough iodine in your system, which is one of the most major deficiencies that we see, along with magnesium and along with hydration. Even though there's water everywhere here, you notice most people are not hydrated. They're actually chronically dehydrated. So that's a very common disease, as we can say, because that disease, chronic dehydration, causes our bodies to get clogged, and it causes everything to be able to not wash. Remember, your body is a liquid machine. It eats food only because it's good for you emotionally. Physically, I get most of my minerals and most of my nutrients from my liquids that I have. And your liquids are the best way to keep your body in shape. You'll find out that if you just eat food all the time, food is just something that is, like I said, it's emotional, and it will feed your emotional body. And if your emotions are not really under control, you're going to eat more than what you need. Just because, why? Because it makes you feel easy. It makes you feel cessational, which is a feeling of fulfillment. So try to, like I said, get into nature, because that's the best reset that you'll ever do, ever. Try to at least drink 100 ounces of water a day and a variety of liquids of vitality that we have lots of different recipes on the internet, or just go to earthshiftproducts.com and you can see all the different types of essential products that are really good to remineralize your system, support detoxification, and support rejuvenation. A lot of the tools, from tongue scrapers to organic tampons, these are all things that you want to really exchange in your world. Exchanging is the program. Remember, you're not here to be a martyr. You're not here to take away anything, but exchange everything for an optimal layer of living. So once you do that in your life, you'll find out that it's really easy to keep your sanity. It's really easy to keep healthy, and it's very easy to keep yourself maintained. Because if you're not maintained, you know what happens? In time, you wind up getting a sickness like obesity. 100 million people in the United States have obesity. Then obesity leads to diabetes, cancer, all these different types of sicknesses, mental sicknesses, emotional sicknesses. You get these sicknesses because your body is full of baggage, different types of heavy metals, different types of particles that have lodged themselves in your lymph system. So once you get this lodging of toxicity in your body, then your door is open, just like my door right here. If I open this door here, this is just like you opening the door into your house, your body, to let everything come in the door. Okay, parasites, fungi, mycobacteria. They don't come inside you because they don't like you. They come inside you because they can. Earther Academy, we go over a lot of these different types of psychological necessities that you really need to know what you're up against to be able to not fight the parasites that live inside you, but negotiate them. Once parasites get inside you, remember, they don't want to leave. Why would they? They just found a nice warm body, and not only found a nice warm body, but they've found themselves a food supply that is always there. Why? It's because their connection to our nervous system is very strong. They hijack our nervous system. When they hijack the nervous system, they hijack everything that's connected to it. Remember, your eyes, your nose, your mouth, your ears, okay? Everything that moves, everything that actually functions in your body is an extension of your nervous system. So one of the most important things is to make sure that you exercise your nervous system and rebuild it. And the only way you can is to follow a lot of the different protocols that we have. The protocols are very simple, and there's many departments to upgrade. Cleaning your skin, opening up your pores, that's a necessity, especially if you live in the city, just because of the pollution and the particulates in the air. Taking showers with chlorine. Chlorine will dry your skin out and clog it. Not only that, but it'll dry your skin out so it cannot function correctly to be able to fight off all the invaders that want to crawl into your skin. So you'd think that chlorine would actually help because it's a disinfectant and actually a poison if you look it up. Just Google chlorine toxicity and you'll see what it is. Look up fluoride and toxicity and you'll see what it is. Look up chemtrails and just sort of read up on it. These are all things that are absorbing in your body, whether you like it or not, just because it's in the terrain of the cities. The water, the food, the air, the electrical magnetics, these are all very, very important parts of what we call terrain modification. And terrain modification, again, is your antidote to optimal health and advanced awareness. And awareness, of course, is very important when you live in a world that has millions of booby traps. And that's another section of the Earther Academy that we go over many of the booby traps, even if it's lead in your lipstick. Mascara, what do you think that stuff's made out of? How about petroleum-based, like diesel? How about putting on makeups, underarm deodorants, putting on different skin lotions? Washing your hair, washing your clothes. Stay away from all the different perfumes, synthetics. Stay away from, if you're eating meat or flesh, stay away from eating meat that is not organic or grass-fed, because that's a bad mistake. Especially if you go to a slaughterhouse, that's one thing. Or just go ahead and research on how they make your food, how they grow your food, how they take care of the animals. You're eating flesh, which you're eating everything, all the memories of the animals. And if they were raised dysfunctional, then all you're doing is grabbing dysfunctionality. Try to stay away from eating anything with a face. Anything with a face, because remember, your DNA has the architectural blueprint of all the living things on the Ark of the Covenant, or the living library, which is this planet. We do live on a planet here that's very special. As you can see, birds, bees, whales, snails, fish, okay, all these species are here on the planet to actually give us enjoyment, okay, to be able to see the miracle of nature all the time. I was just looking at these beautiful swans a minute ago. Like I said, and if you believe in evolution, you've been taught a good tale. So how did all these species get here? Well, that's a matter of opinion. My opinion, of course, is that everything was created. Who created it? Again, that's a matter of opinion. We do live in a 100 trillion star galaxy, 100 trillion stars, and of course there's millions and millions of other planets and moons, and we do also live in a universe that has billions of known galaxies. So if that's the case, you can see how, well, the cosmos is very big. So thinking that you're the only divine organism in this galaxy is very foolish indeed. We at this time are learning that we are part of the cosmos. We are part of this intergalactic web of life. We are all connected to everything and anything that you see. Just remember that. So when you're walking around, really just look at the miracle of all the plants, the animals, the birds, and study them. They are here to teach us many things. One of the axioms I like to use is to study nature and you will see the secrets of the universe. Okay? Remember, the programs of animals have not been wiped clean. They don't go to school to learn how to eat. They don't go to school to learn how to have sexual activity or take care of their children. We, as supposedly Earth humans, as you've noticed, we don't know too many things. In fact, we don't know anything unless we're taught them or unless we experience them. So experience life in a different direction that is being pushed to you synthetically. Experience life in more of a naturalistic lifestyle. And this lifestyle we call is called the supernatural lifestyle. I guarantee you, practicing this lifestyle for 6 months, you will change the way you see, the way you feel, the way you hear, and just the way you marvel at the world, because it is a marvelous, marvelous thing. We do live on a little tiny little pale blue dot, and if you haven't seen that, look up Dr. Carl Sagan, the pale blue dot, and you can see the miraculous cosmos in a different light. Also look up the powers of 10, so you could go ahead and look out powers of 10 as far as you can, not see, but as far as you can go, and then go inside yourself powers of 10 and look and see where it goes. Also, you can see we go infinitely inside or inside the body, and we go infinitely outside. So from atoms to cosmos, everything is a simple physical and or non-physical holograph, which is pretty incredible. Okay, we'll see you, and I'll give you another update coming up. Okay, bye.
Important reminder. All information and ideas are for informational purposes only and are in no way intended as medical advice or as a substitute for medical counseling. Earthshift Products, Dr. Robert Cassar, all of their partners, affiliates, and subsidiaries will not be held accountable for the use or misuse of the information presented therein. This information is not intended as medical advice. The authors, publishers, and speakers of this work are not medical doctors and do not recommend the use of mineral-deficient foods, drugs, or medicines to achieve beauty and to alleviate health challenges. Because there is always some risk involved, all persons involved with the development and distribution of this information are not responsible for any adverse effects or consequences of any kind resulting from the use or misuse of any suggestions or procedures described on our website or Earthshift Live radio talk show or therein.